السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. إنا لله وإنا إليه راجعون. To Allah we belong and to Allah we shall all return. It's unfortunate that we're having to discuss this topic, which is about knife crime and which is about gang culture and the kind of mindset that people, some people have, in which they think killing is allowed, killing is okay, killing is permissible. But this is something that is extremely grave in the sight of Allah and the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. We know the ayahs of the Quran, that whoever kills and takes a life unjustifiably, that it is as though that they have killed the entire human population. And we also know the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, numerous hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam, that tells us that the punishment for the killer is hellfire. And this is how strong the admonition is against indiscriminate killing. And what we're seeing in this country, you know, a country of safety and security, where people have clothing and food and they have housing and they have systems of support and they have education, people are killing one another over the most mundane and most ridiculous of things. And this is really saddening. And it's happening within our own Muslim community, and that harms the heart even more. In the month of Ramadan, people are being killed over gang culture. People are being killed over drugs. People are being killed over wealth. People are being killed over football. This is how sad the state has become. And so we need to take action. We need to take a stance, and we need to ensure that our future is free of these kinds of crimes. And one of the ways that we can do that is to ensure that we make our children aware that this life is very sacred to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We do not have the right to take the life of somebody else. This life has been granted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Nobody has the right to take the life of anybody else. And also that we avoid exposing them to that kind of culture that glorifies killings. That's through computer games. Children play computer games that desensitizes killing and death, almost glorifies and celebrates it. Games like Fortnite, games like Call of Duty, games like Grand Theft Auto. We're mentioning them by name because these are the things which seem like a game to us, but if you actually look at what's taking place, it's the glorification of killing, and it's a desensitization of killing and blood and the spilling of blood. And this can then lead to children considering life to not be sacred. We also need to ensure that we read to them the stories of those in the past, how sacred they held life, the life of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam, and how the hadith that he mentions about the sanctity of life and about the protection of life and the reward for protecting life and the reward for saving people from death and the punishment for those who take other people's lives without necessity. And what parents need to really do is really ensure that they are in tune with their children and know what's happening in their lives, steering them away from being in company which glorifies or pushes them towards being involved in violence in any way whatsoever. That's not the way of the Muslim. Muslim is a person who is a person of peace by name and a person of peace by nature. And so this Ramadan, we need to ensure that every single individual takes individual responsibility for themselves, their family. Make sure that we do not have any of this kind of culture taking place in our households. We're seeing a young person who was killed the other day in Bradford over football. You know, people brawling in the early mornings, and people, you know, in London, somebody was killed defending somebody else. You know, a young brother was killed again in those lands over what? He was over wealth. You know, he was selling jackets and somebody tried to rob him and he was defending his mother. People being killed. And so this is something that we really need to take seriously. And we need, first of all, to make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He protects us from this, and that we now do not allow another precious life to be lost over this kind of senseless and barbaric behavior and the killing of others, inshallah. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He protects us and our loved ones and our families and our communities, Ya Rabbil Alameen, and He guides those who have this kind of mentality and protects us from them. Ameen, Ya Rabbil Alameen, wa sallallahu ala Sayyidina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam.